Hey, I'm Blogging Brandy, and I've been using Wix to design my new website. In this video, I'm showing you how to start writing, editing, and adding elements to your new Wix blog post. Now, you can write and manage blog posts from your mobile device, or what I like to do is manage them from my desktop, and I'll be using my laptop for this tutorial. Now, there are a few ways to access and manage your blog posts. I'm going to show you both of these. First is going to be live on your website, and second will be using the back end of your website with your Wix website editor. How you can do this live from your site, either to add new posts, edit existing posts, or manage comments. So for viewers that are not logged in and on your live site, they're going to see either this login tab up here, or if you set it up, they're also going to see this login sign up tab on the page in the top right. They're not really going to have a whole lot of options other than to read the blog, or they can share the post, and then they're going to have to log in to write a comment. But this is essentially the page that I'm talking about when I'm talking about your live site. You'd actually have to be signed in and have writing permissions to do anything as far as editing the post. So these are existing posts. I'm going to show you how you could actually edit this if you're signed in. So we're going to go ahead and sign in. And this is the sign up page. If you've already signed up, you're going to be prompted to log in either with Facebook, your Gmail account, or with an email account. And once I'm actually logged in, now you can see that I have more options. I can create a new post up here with this tab, or I can edit an existing post. And now I have the option not only to share the post, but unfollow, edit, share, pin to feed, turn off commenting, or delete the post. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to access your blog posts and edit them or add a new one if you're in the actual Wix website editor. So the first page is your home page, and then you can select from the drop downs to go over to your actual blog page. And if you click on the blog page, either double click, you'll see this tab come up. You can manage posts, create a new post, or change some of your settings here for your layouts and design. Or you can hit manage posts. It's going to take you to this page where it tells you your author name. This is what you're creating posts as, and any drafts that you have, or published posts. So if there's drafts here, or publish posts, those are gonna be here. And then you can either edit them from here by selecting the edit tab. If you wanna create a new post, you'll see this huge button up here that says create new post. And then you also have the option to access your blog. If you go to my blog over here on the left-hand side, and you see blog manager, manage posts, or create a post. No matter whether you access a post on your live site or through the post manager, the process of writing a post is the same. Simply enter the post title and then write your post. I'm just going to add one of my videos that I've already done, how I got started making YouTube videos. That's going to be my title, and then I'm just going to use the description from my video, and you can clean this up and put some spaces in it. If I want to add a divider tab, I can add a divider tab, and I'll add a second divider line. So all I'm doing is just adding in the divider line, and then it gives me options for, do I want to make it small, medium, large? So say I wanted to add a photo, I can add an image with this option and upload media, either my own beautiful face or something media from Wix. So they have thousands of free images that you can choose from in here. You can put a gallery of photos together and insert, or you can add a video. You can also select the add button and add in a video as well. So if we added in a video, go over to YouTube, we can hit the share button and get the link for the video here. And then I'm just going to add the video from YouTube, but you can also use one from another service like Facebook. I'm going to hit add now, and then I can choose how I want the video to look, either small, best fit, or full width if I want it to be full width. And then you can choose to align left or align right of any text that you might have, and then you can replace the video or delete. This text is already highlighted because I copied it over. I added a link here just by selecting the text and adding the link, but you can also add a link to, say, checklist if I just wanted to add it there and say open in a new tab. And then if I wanted to include something like a hashtag, if you just put hashtag and then the term, it's gonna
going to highlight it for you. I would always look at my posts, and of course I would make any changes I could before I publish, but if there's something that you want to add, so say you said, oh my gosh, I forgot I wanted to add this quote in here, I would put it in quotations here. And you may or may not want to add these, but you can choose the layout that you want for this. And here's your alignment. So maybe you want it to be in the middle of the page. Maybe you want it to be bold and italicized. And then you can choose, do you want it to be a title one or title two? There's so many things that you can do on here. So if you had topic one, and you wanted to add a bullet to this, so that's numbers, there's bullet points, and then you can change the alignment or make it bold, italicized, same thing. We can add HTML code if we wanted to do that. We would just want to make sure that we publish changes and select publish changes. And then of course the post settings are those categories, SEO and general information that I can change. So say I wanted to change the date of this, I could change that to be the date here if I chose to. So maybe I wanted this to be November 11th, I can change that here. And then the author, this is the cover image that's gonna show, which is the image from the video, but I can change the cover image, or I can choose a category, I can add a new category. Maybe I wanna call this YouTube videos, and then I can also add it to the getting started if I would like. And I can put any SEO updates that I would like to change in here. And this shows me what it's gonna preview like on Google. So I can choose to save that here and publish it to my site. You can see on the back end here it is, and it shows that it was just published. And then I can choose to duplicate the post, delete the post, turn off commenting if I don't want any commenting. And if I want to edit it, I can select edit and make any edits here. And then you just publish your changes.
If you need more help, you can watch tutorials just like this one by visiting the description below this video. I'm Blogging Brandy. You can reach me on social at Blogging Brandy, or find out more about me on my website, www.bloggingbrandy.com.